Hello and welcome to AFO Proving Grounds. My name is Peter Zimbor and this is a weekly episodic program dedicated to the American Fighting Organization, a New England-based MMA league that calls its home field the Holiday Inn Event Center in Mansfield, Massachusetts. That's where we'll be this coming Friday night, October 8th, for AFO Halloween Havoc. And here to discuss that with me is AFO President Pete DiLorenzo. First off, Pete, we're on television. The AFO, your baby, is making its TV debut. You've got to be excited.
I am. I'm very excited. You know, going into our third year to see how far we've come and where we're going, this is first step of many for us.
Let's talk a little bit about the card we've got this Friday night. Welterweight championship fight in our main event. Tim O'Connell takes on Paddy Thompson, a rematch. Tell us about these two fighters and what about their first contest warrants a rematch this Friday night.
Well, Paddy went into the first contest as champion last February. He was a great champ at that. He defended his title as often as we needed him to. Timmy was working his way up. Paddy was the heavy favorite going into that fight, but Timmy really took it to him. He caught him by surprise and was able to choke him out. Being what a good champ that Paddy was, he deserved the rematch just 6 months later, so it's going to happen.
I'm sure O'Connell and Thompson will not be looking ahead of one another for this upcoming fight this Friday, but earlier on in the evening, their next opponent for the winner will be determined in an AFO welterweight title eliminator. Brockton, Massachusetts' own Steve the Sandman Dunn makes his AFO debut, taking on John Downey. The winner of this fight automatically will get a title shot in his next bout. You got to be excited to see the Sandman in an AFO cage.
Yeah, this is about 8-9 months in the works now. We've been talking to Steve, and we wanted to make sure that we could get him in this cage at some point. And when the timing was right, we'd make it happen, and that's exactly what we did. John Downey, we have worked with in the past. Great guy, great team. He's been calling out Steve for almost a year now, so timing's everything. You know, the winner falls right into that number one title slot.
Well, looks like we've got a great card this Friday in Mansfield. Great main event. Great everything from top to bottom. That was also the case with AFO 13 this past August, also at the Holiday Inn Event Center in Mansfield, Massachusetts. The main event that night had two unbeaten fighters taking on one another, Nate Andrews and Tyson Chartier. I was on hand to call that fight alongside Mark Daniels, and now we take a look back at AFO 13's main event, Andrews versus Chartier. Well, it's time for the main event of the evening here at AFO 13 on AnySportsTV.com. Undefeated welterweights. Tyson Chartier coming in with a record of 6-0, taking on the 2-0 Nathan Andrews. Tyson Chartier, a former standout amateur wrestler, comes from a family of six kids, taking on Nate Andrews, a former standout at East Providence High School on the football field. He categorizes himself as a boxing Andrew. Jiu-Jitsu fighter, Chartier, more of a straight-up wrestler. What can you tell us about these fighters? What do you know, Mark?
You know, Tyson Chartier is one of the more well-known amateur fighters around here. You know, this is his last amateur fight. He's 6-0. That record speaks for itself. I mean, the fact that he is a purple belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and a member of Seiyo Tong has to make you wonder, you know, how do you beat this guy? Do you take him to the ground or do you do it standing up?
And he's been saying he knows that people fear his ground game because of his Jiu-Jitsu and wrestling credentials. He wants people to fear his stand-up game as well. He wants to be well-rounded by time he turns pro, which could be pretty soon, as promoter Pete DiLorenzo told us earlier. And Nate Andrews tonight, he's going to have to deal with a guy with a height advantage, but we know wrestlers can shoot and take away that advantage instantly.
Oh, exactly. You used to see Nate Andrews right away. He has the reach advantage. He has the height advantage. And Tyson shoots in from far away.
Yeah, that didn't take very long, did it, Mark?
Not at all.
Come on, overhand. And a nice overhand right by Chartier lands on Andrews. And he once again shoots, thinks better of it, back up on his feet.
Head kick attempt.
That's where it is, Tyson. That's where it is.
He just has that build of a wrestler, Tyson Chartier.
He definitely does. You know, he has a cool haircut to go along with it.
Interesting, when I asked him what he knows about his opponent, one of the things he mentioned was his cool haircut.
A nice trip takedown into Andrew's guard for Chartier.
Posture, Tyson. Posture when you feel good, man. Posture when you feel good. Make him work a little bit. Make him work.
Come on, Tyson!
Now you see Andrews locking up the body triangle. It makes it tough for your opponent to kind of move around, posture up, and rain down punches onto your face. It also restricts their breathing a little bit, but not too much. Oh, and he let it go.
Head up first, man, with the hand on the neck.
Tyson listening to his corner going body, body, head. But you see Andrews threw up the legs there for possible submission attempts.
Hips in, Tyson.
Tyson doing the right thing, trying to pass right now.
Look the strike. There you go.
Tyson moves over to side control. Let's see if he can put some ground and pound work in.
And you could see Nate Andrews trying to buck his way out of it. But Jardier using his body weight just to lay right on top of him, not letting him move.
Andrews seems to be doing some of the right things. He seems to be trying to improve his position. You see, Chardy had side control. Now, you know, he's back into half guard. Andrews trying to control his left leg there a little bit. Chartier trying to pass, trying to get his left leg over Andrews up, and Andrews able to reverse.
Chartier may have Andrews in a little bit of a guillotine. It's unable for us to see, but nevertheless, Andrews pops his head out. I thought he had the guillotine in a little bit, obviously not too tight since he popped out pretty soon after.
And now we see Andrews in the top position in Chartier's half guard. Let's see how you know Chartier's jiu-jitsu and wrestling off his back is. Oh, and just as I spoke, Chartier is able to reverse, get into Andrews' guard.
First round comes to an end. Tyson Chartier dominant through round one, but Andrews not taking much of a beating, but a clear round for Tyson Chartier as we enter the second of this scheduled three-rounder. Don't go anywhere. We have round two and more of AFO Proving Grounds after this break. AFO Proving Grounds is brought to you by Warhawk Fightwear. Get your fightwear at www.warhawkfightwear.com and at AFO Live Events. And by Allaire Fitness. Located in Woonsocket, Rhode Island, Allaire Fitness is the training facility to some of your favorite AFO fighters and a great place to get in shape. Visit them online at AllaireFitness.com. And now we're back with more AFO Proving Grounds.
Fight fans, don't forget to mark your calendar for October 8th for Halloween Havoc, the rematch between Patty Thunderkitten Thompson and the man who took his title, the new AFO welterweight champion, Tim Watchaback O'Connell, along with a great Kofi
corner of Nate Andrews,
DJ Marino, and Christian Rivera, and see other favorites such as
looking like they're trying to get some energy back into him, shaking his arms. Probably exerted a lot of energy trying to get Tyson Chartier off him through the first round.
Luis Felix over there in his corner of Team Rockstar.
Fight fans, you need to
and of course,
the
in Chartier's corner, we got Mark Delagrati. Also see Judo Olympian Rick Hahn.
Some fans rising for their fighter and Nate Andrews, telling him stay calm as Chartier throws a leg at his legs. You know, one thing that wasn't noticeable through the first round because of the fact that Andrews is on the ground a lot was he's a southpaw when he stands up.
He is, yeah, which would be very unorthodox and tough for opponents to deal with, especially amateurs who may be not used to it. That being said, Chartier is a very well-experienced amateur fighter. And now Chartier getting right to the full mount, listening to his corner very well. Again, you see Andrews trying to buck, trying to do the right things, and now by bucking, you see he's now in the half guard position.
Okay.
able to get Charity back into his guard. Trying to posture up.
It looks like he's trying to create some distance, maybe to rain some blows onto Andrews, but he finds himself right back in his guard again.
Andrews did the smart thing there, tried to wrap him up. That's the last thing you want, is him hovering over you and throwing down punches. But again, Andrews trying to roll off the cage a bit there.
Come on, Tyson, there you go. Head up, head up.
Chardy with a nice left hook from the guard.
There you go.
Andrew seems to have a fairly active guard, though.
That's how I see. Control the legs. Control the legs. Control the legs. There you go. Hips in.
Chardy able to pass. Now your Andrews is going to want to stand up. However, it looks like Chardy has him in a guillotine. Oh, and he taps.
And Nate Andrews taps out. Tyson Chardier stays unbeaten. He submits Nate Andrews in the second round with a guillotine choke. Tyson Chardier dominant from the get-go of that fight. What did he do right, Mark?
Yeah, Chardier was great, executed his game plan perfectly. He was able to take Andrews down, you know, impose his will on him, and then, you know, show us, you know, his jiu-jitsu. He looked good, really, the two rounds of the fight. I thought Chardier looked very well, and you know what? Hopefully the next time we'll see him, he'll be as a pro.
Tyson Chardier, if he does turn pro in his next fight, will end his amateur career, a perfect one, at 7-0, as it looks like we're having some difficulty with the lighting here in the facility. But MMA obviously being a rather new sport to the masses. 7-0 for Tyson Chardier. Is 7 amateur fights enough for a guy at this stage in the evolution of MMA to turn pro? Because take a look at boxing. Guys have hundreds of amateur fights that turn
MMA,
pro.
MMA, you know, it's so different than boxing, that aspect, because you see a lot of fighters who don't go through the amateur ranks. I think 7 is a perfect amount. You know, I see a lot of fighters with 1, 2, 3 amateur fights when they turn pro.
2 minutes, 14 seconds of round number 2. Referee Gary Eblen stops this contest. Your winner by tap out on a guillotine and still undefeated, Tyson Chardier.
Don't go anywhere. We'll continue with more AFO Proving Grounds after this break. Nothing is like MMA action live, and no one does it better than the American Fighting Organization. See all the crushing knockouts, slick submissions, and hard-hitting fights for yourself. Visit AFOMMA.com to get your tickets to the next AFO live event. Coming October 29th to AnySportsTV.com online pay-per-view, it's the return of former world title challenger Brian the Beast Minto. Watch Minto as he takes on Corey Phelps in a 10-round cruiserweight fight live from Butler, Pennsylvania. AnySportsTV.com online pay-per-view, the pay-per-view of the future. And we're back here on AFO Proving Grounds. Remember, all the information you need about AFO MMA can be found at AFOMMA.com. Peter Zimbor still here with AFO President Pete DiLorenzo. This next fight we're going to show our fans. Let's file this one under quick but good.
This is fantastic. I was sitting with Mark Delgrati for this one. He said, don't move. This is going to be a ridiculously good fight. One way or the other, somebody's getting knocked out, and we almost had both.
Well, folks, the bathroom break can wait. The beverage can wait. This is Jeff Bermani taking on Joe Powers from AFO 13.
Joe
Well, what will end up being our co-main event tonight, our semifinal, if you will, welterweights. Joe Powers taking on Jeff Bermani. Jeff Bermani will be in the blue trunks. Joseph Powers will be in the white trunks. Evenly matched contest. Powers enters with a record of one win and one loss. Jeff Bermani, who's on your screen right now, he's entering this fight with a record of 1-0 and a considerable fan base in attendance.
I would say, but you know what? Training with Sitio Tong, with the world-renowned trainer Mark Delagrotti. This school knows how to develop fighters. We've seen it with Kenny Florian, Marcus Davis, Patrick Coté, George Grigel, you know, Alex Karalexis. I mean, he comes with a very, very good camp, and let's see if it translates to here in the cage.
Delagrotti working with a who's who in mixed martial arts, as you just mentioned. So much so that fighters even outside of this region and area now calling him in.
Yeah, Frank Mir, Miguel Torres, both guys coming out firing. You always love to see that when the fight starts. This guy's going at it.
Bermani loves that right kick.
Oh, he is right. He is out cold. A beautiful right, Bermani.
Yeah, Jeff Bermani landed a crisp overhand right on the button of Joe Powers. Put him out, that will be a first-round knockout for Jeff Bermani.
He was out before
Bermani.
He hit the ground. Knockout of the night.
And the interesting thing is, good job by our official as Bermani went in to throw a little extra Susie Q punch in on Powers
that's
on the ground.
For amateur fights, the referees are supposed to be careful with the fighters. Stop them a little quicker. And Fred Mello was right on top of that one.
We'll categorize that one under fun while it lasted.
That was extremely entertaining for the how many seconds it was. And again, Sitio Tong representing here in Massachusetts.
And what's Mark Delagrotti's specialty? He's a stand-up fighter. It looks like one of his guys just did.
We saw it all there, Peter. We saw kicks, we saw punches, and we saw someone get knocked out.
Well, we'll get the official particulars what the time of the knockout was, but Jeff Bermani with a KO of Joe Powers.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time. 21 seconds of the first round. Referee Fred Mello stops his contest. He winner by TKO victory and still undefeated, Jeff Bermani.
Well, a fun 21 seconds. Jeff Bermani improves to 2-0, still undefeated. Joe Powers falls to one win with two losses now on his record. But a fun 21 seconds it was as Bermani prevails over Powers.
It was very fun. And as we see here, Jeff Bermani, bachelor's in criminal justice for Salem State. Well, what he just did would be a crime in many states, I think, Peter.
Well, for those astute listeners and astute viewers out there, you may have noticed you could hear my voice calling the action of that last fight as an overhand right knockout for Jeff Bermani over Joe Powers. However, we nearly had a double knockdown and potentially a double knockout with the way things panned out.
Yeah, you very well could have called or almost called Joe Powers overhand right knockout on Jeff. When these punches were thrown, Joe hit Jeff more or less on the nose. Jeff hit Joe pretty clean on the jaw. When Jeff hit that cage, Jeff was out. The only problem was, so was Joe.
Yeah, Jeff Bermani really benefited from his positioning inside the cage. The cage was at his back, helping him stay upright. Joe Powers didn't quite have the same situation.
No, he didn't have the situation. He hit the canvas. Jeff followed up correctly, and the referee stopped it.
Well, Jeff Bermani's striking coach is the world-famous Mark Delagrotti, who's worked with some of MMA's best, including Frank Mir and Kenny Florian, amongst others. I spoke with him after that bout about Jeff Bermani's knockout, and here's what he had to say. Still here at AFO 13 on AnySportsTV.com. Peter Zimbor here with world-class striking coach Mark Delagrotti. Mark, moments ago we saw Jeff Bermani with a one-punch KO of Joe Powers. Only took him 21 seconds. You like what you see?
Absolutely. You know, Jeff's a tough kid. You know, he's good inside the gym. He's quiet. He's a hard worker. You know, and that's the type of guy we look for. And when we're training a fighter at Sitio Tong, and told Jeff just to go out there, lay it on the line. Don't be intimidated by anybody. Take it one win at a time and try to achieve your goals in small increments. And just worry about getting through one thing tonight, and that's the win. And Jeff went out there and he went after it, and it showed in his performance that he's a diehard fighter, and he's willing to take chances to make the fight exciting.
Fight only lasted 21 seconds. Obviously, you like the result at the amateur level. Do you think he got much out of the experience, even though it lasted so quickly?
You know, any experience is a good experience. You know, whether it's a 21-second fight or it's a 21-minute fight. You know, ring time is good time as far as I'm concerned. And especially as an amateur, I like to keep him busy. He's coming off a win recently. And like I said, I like to keep my guys active, keep the ball rolling, keep the ring rust off, which is a real thing. People misconstrue that to be fake. And I'm all about keeping the guys busy. I like to keep Jeff as active as he can and keep the wins coming through for him.
And I hope we can see you once again here at AFO in October.
Always a pleasure. AFO always puts on exciting bouts. It's always a pleasure to be part of it.
It's Mark Delagrotti joining us here, AFO on AnySportsTV.com.
Don't go anywhere. We'll continue with more AFO Proving Grounds after this break. AFO Proving Grounds is brought to you by Warhawk Fightwear. Get your fightwear at www.warhawkfightwear.com and at AFO Live Events. And by Allaire Fitness. Located in Woonsocket, Rhode Island, Allaire Fitness is the training facility to some of your favorite AFO fighters and a great place to get in shape. Visit them online at AllaireFitness.com. Nothing is like MMA action live, and no one does it better than the American Fighting Organization. See all the crushing knockouts, slick submissions, and hard-hitting fights for yourself. Visit AFOMMA.com to get your tickets to the next AFO live event. Coming October 29th to AnySportsTV.com online pay-per-view, it's the return of former world title challenger Brian the Beast Minto. Watch Minto as he takes on Corey Phelps in a 10-round cruiserweight fight live from Butler, Pennsylvania. AnySportsTV.com online pay-per-view, the pay-per-view of the future. Well, we've taken a look at some of the better moments of recent AFO events here on this broadcast. We're now going to look ahead to this Friday night, October 8th, at the Holiday Inn Event Center in Mansfield, Massachusetts, AFO's Halloween Havoc. Peter Zimber once again here with Pete DiLorenzo. We talked about the main event earlier on in the broadcast, Paddy Thompson taking on Tim O'Connell, AFO welterweight championship bout. We've seen these two in the cage once before. What can we expect in the rematch?
I think going into this fight, Paddy has a new respect for Timmy's ground game. I know Timmy's been working very hard at his stand-up. I would imagine Paddy's going to want to keep this fight standing, while Timmy's going to want to take it right back to the ground and repeat what he did in February.
Yeah, their first fight went just a little over a minute. I think we can expect this one not to go any longer, not to go any shorter, but just to expect it to be just as explosive.
This will definitely be an explosive fight, one way or the other. Whoever gets their hand raised, these guys have put a lot of time in preparing for this fight.
And another fight we touched on a little bit earlier, welterweight title eliminator earlier on in the evening. Steve the Sandman Dunn of Brockton, Massachusetts, makes his AFO debut in a welterweight title eliminator, no less, taking on John Downey. You talked earlier about how John Downey picked this fight. He's been asking for it. Well, he got it.
He's got it, and you know that old saying, be careful what you wish for because you might just get it. And you know this is going to be another one. Both these guys are going to have a huge fan base. I'm definitely, as a fan, looking forward to seeing this fight.
One fight we haven't mentioned yet is a 135-pound bout between Ken Stone and Jay Bonnet. Ken Stone, you've referred to as the best pound-for-pound fighter in New England. We're in a region that has produced fighters such as Marcus Davis, Kenny Florian, Joe Lauzon, Jorge Rivera. What about Ken Stone makes him the number one guy pound for pound?
You know, Kenny is a very, very dynamic fighter. He's very athletic. He's got great grappling skills, wrestling, jiu-jitsu. His stand-up is superb. You know, he trains for a living. It's what he does. It's who he's supposed to be. Having Kenny come back to New England for this fight, for me, is fantastic. Kenny had his last four or five fights with the AFO. He won our AFO title. I'm thrilled to have him back in the cage. I hope I can get him in a couple more before he heads off to WEC.
Well, rounding out the card, we've got plenty of other interesting fights. What else do we have in store for AFO Halloween Havoc this Friday night?
We have a great rematch with Sloppy Joe out of South Shore versus Mike Zatek. Joe has one defeat on his record, and that's to Mike Zatek. This is a rematch that he's been asking for as well for about 6 months, and he finally has that one. BJ Marino continues on his comeback trail as he looks for a title shot in the 145-pound division as he faces Christian Rivera. For Christian, you know, this is make or break for him. You know, he says he's got a new game plan coming in, and he's going to shock a lot of people, and I'm looking forward to that one. Ricardo Georges versus Joe Palacio. We have two very skilled, very talented fighters. It's going to be a great night.
Where and when was the nickname Sloppy Joe coined?
You know, I honestly couldn't tell you. That's something that Joe's going to have to answer, so I'm sure at some episode down the road, you know, you'll have him on. Joe is as charismatic as it comes. He is hands down one of the biggest crowd pleasers in MMA right now. I always enjoy watching him. My kids enjoy watching him. You know, it's he puts on a great show. You know, win or lose, and he's won far more than he's lost, but he puts on a fantastic show.
Well, we look forward to probably inquiring as to the origination of the nickname Sloppy Joe in future episodes of AFO Proving Grounds. We also look forward to this Friday night at the Holiday Inn Event Center in Mansfield, Massachusetts for AFO Halloween Havoc. Should be a good time. We hope to see you there. And then we hope you join us once again next Saturday at 11 a.m. right here. For everyone here at the AFO, President Pete DiLorenzo, I'm Peter Zimbor. We'll see you at the fights. Proving Grounds is brought to you by Warhawk Fightwear. Get your fightwear at www.warhawkfightwear.com and at AFO Live Events. And by Allaire Fitness. Located in Woonsocket, Rhode Island, Allaire Fitness is the training facility to some of your favorite AFO fighters and a great place to get in shape. Visit them online at AllaireFitness.com. Nothing is like MMA action live, and no one does it better than the American Fighting Organization. See all the crushing knockouts, slick submissions, and hard-hitting fights for yourself. Visit AFOMMA.com to get your tickets to the next AFO live event. Coming October 29th to AnySportsTV.com online pay-per-view, it's the return of former world title challenger Brian the Beast Minto. Watch Minto as he takes on Corey Phelps in a 10-round cruiserweight fight live from Butler, Pennsylvania. AnySportsTV.com online pay-per-view, the pay-per-view of the future. AFO Proving Grounds is brought to you by Warhawk Fightwear. Get your fightwear at www.warhawkfightwear.com and at AFO Live Events. And by Allaire Fitness. Located in Woonsocket, Rhode Island, Allaire Fitness is the training facility to some of your favorite AFO fighters and a great place to get in shape. Visit them online at AllaireFitness.com.